The Pediatric Diabetes Program at Johns Hopkins Children's Center offers a comprehensive, multidisciplinary team approach to the care of our children and their families with diabetes. We care for all kinds of diabetes, including type 1, type 2, cystic fibrosis-related diabetes, steroid-induced hyperglycemia or diabetes, neonatal diabetes, and Modi diabetes. Our comprehensive multidisciplinary team approach encompasses both the inpatient and outpatient hospital experience. Our approach begins at the time of diagnosis for children with diabetes during their inpatient hospitalization. Our comprehensive care includes our diabetes providers, our pediatric endocrinologists, as well as nutritionists, our behavioral health or psychology team, as well as our diabetes nurses who provide a lot of our education. We provide a supportive environment during the inpatient hospitalization as well as an outpatient. And from the time the patient is discharged from the hospital, we speak with our families every single day, going over blood sugars and allowing them to ask any questions that have come up since their hospitalization as a way to provide support until their first follow-up visit, which is usually within 2 weeks of discharge. We provide a comprehensive diabetes care approach at two locations, one at the Johns Hopkins Children's Center downtown, as well as at Mount Washington Pediatric Hospital. Both of these sites have a comprehensive team, including medical assistants, diabetes nurse educators, nutritionists, psychologists, and their diabetes provider being a pediatric endocrinologist or diabetes nurse practitioner. Everybody has a critical role in the care of our patients with diabetes. Our medical assistants help us with downloading insulin pumps, continuous glucose monitors, and doing a point of care A1C, which means that the child can have their hemoglobin A1C level checked with just a finger stick as opposed to going to the laboratory to have their blood drawn. Our diabetes educators provide a lot of support and resources answering questions on the day-to-day management of diabetes. Our nutritionists are available at every visit to provide additional education and coaching on carbohydrate counting, meal planning, dealing with different age ranges, toddlers who might be picky eaters, as well as adolescents who are thinking about doing a lot more carbohydrate counting on their own. We also have a unique component, which is the Kennedy Krieger Institute Behavioral Health Team, who provides psychology support at our diabetes center. At the time of hospitalization for a diagnosis, they provide a lot of guidance on coping and managing a new chronic disease. And then throughout the care of a child with diabetes, they are there to support for diabetes distress, as well as anxiety and depression and other mental health disorders that may arise throughout childhood. Finally, our diabetes providers provide an oversight to the medical team and help with adjusting insulin doses, screening for complications, and making sure that the child is and the family are working towards to optimize glycemic control, meeting the American Diabetes Association guidelines of having a hemoglobin A1C of less than 7.5%, so that we can keep our children healthy forever. The incidence of type 2 diabetes in children has increased by over 30% over the last decade, with a prevalence rate of over 15% now in youth and adolescents. This has changed significantly concurrent with the obesity epidemic, where more than 18 to 20% of kids will be overweight or obese. Our diabetes center, again, takes a multidisciplinary approach, providing a lot of resources and lifestyle modifications to help our children with type 2 diabetes. That is a critical component of their care, and our nutritionists spend a lot of time with them working on creating a healthy diet, improving their lifestyle, and the whole team approach is to use motivational interviewing to stimulate the patient to take on responsibility and to set easy, feasible goals that they can reach in order to improve their lifestyle. The other component of this is that with the increased risk for obesity, we're also seeing a lot more prediabetes in children. Now, they don't have full-blown diabetes, but they have elevated blood sugars, and they require the same interventions in terms of lifestyle modification. So we have opened up our practice to seeing a lot of children with prediabetes in order to help provide additional resources to them to help them prevent the onset of type 2 diabetes. Unfortunately, children with type 2 diabetes are also at risk for diabetes complications in a shorter time course than our children with type 1 diabetes. So we always screen for those complications immediately after the time of diagnosis, and we do a lot of that in our clinic, again, by checking labs, doing their blood pressure, as well as screening for diabetic retinopathy in our clinic at the time that they are there, making it a convenient, comprehensive visit for our patients. As a division, we are very involved with the Juvenile Diabetes Research Foundation, as well as the American Diabetes Association, and multiple diabetes camps throughout our local region. The Juvenile Diabetes Research Foundation, or JDRF, hosts many events throughout the year that we encourage our families to be involved in, including the JDRF Walk, the JDRF Gala, as well as the Type 1 Diabetes Summit that occurs once a year. Last year together, we co-sponsored two events with them. We had Ryan Reed, a NASCAR driver with type 1 diabetes, come to Johns Hopkins to speak to our children, and he was very inspirational and motivational to them in knowing that they could achieve whatever their dreams were. Additionally, we hosted the first off-to-college diabetes transition event for our children transitioning from pediatric to adult diabetes care and going off to college, and we co-sponsored that event with the JDRF and the College Diabetes Network. Additionally, we are involved with the American Diabetes Association. I am personally a member of their Camp Medical Leadership Committee, and we work on developing policies and procedures for diabetes camps throughout the nation. With that in mind, we are joining forces with the ADA this summer, and we'll be starting the first diabetes camp for children with diabetes in Baltimore City, Camp Charm City, and we'll be working very closely with them on that. In addition, our staff and our team participates at other diabetes camps in the region. Last year, we participated in Diabetes Destiny, and a lot of our patients also attend Camp Possibilities. So there are a lot of opportunities, and we hope to increase the access to these resources by having our own camp in Baltimore City next summer. Technological advancements in diabetes have made significant changes over the last 5 to 10 years. All of our diabetes providers, diabetes nurses, and nutritionists are very well versed and knowledgeable in all the devices that are constantly changing for our patients. Insulin can be provided and administered in several different ways. It can be with a syringe and needle as an injection. You can use an insulin pen, which looks like this, with the needle on top, or an insulin pump, which looks like this is just one example of an insulin pump. The benefit of insulin pumps is that instead of having to do 4 to 5 injections every day, you put it on once every 3 days. So it gives a benefit of fewer injections. We can have more fine-tuned control of diabetes. It offers a little bit more flexibility in terms of eating and exercise, and has been associated with fewer hypoglycemic episodes or low blood sugar events. We also support our patients in using continuous glucose monitors, which is a very small device that you wear on your skin that has a very small wire that sits subcutaneously and reads the blood sugar at a continuous rate. So it provides blood sugar monitoring 24/7 and sends that data to a receiver that can actually go to a phone or even a smartwatch. So you can monitor blood sugars remotely with that. The benefits of these devices is that it even shows the direction that the blood sugar is moving and has alerts for highs and lows so that it helps prevent low blood sugars in our children and pediatric patients with diabetes. There are several systems on the market that integrate the continuous glucose monitors and the insulin pumps, and we support our patients in using these new technologies and as a team stay up to date on all of them so that we can provide as much information as possible to our patients. We offer opportunities to our patients to provide in research studies related to diabetes at our institution, as well as national and international research studies. We are a site for TrialNet, which includes pathway to prevention. So family members of children with diabetes can be screened for antibodies that may predispose them to developing diabetes. We are also a site for the Pediatric Diabetes Consortium, and we run studies using new medications in the care of children with type 2 diabetes. In the field of cystic fibrosis-related diabetes, one of our providers is doing research on the genetic and metabolic components of that and how it develops in as a complication of cystic fibrosis. We also have several type 2 diabetes studies going on. And as a way to improve our clinical care, we also are doing a study on the implementation of point-of-care diabetic retinopathy screening in children with diabetes at our center. Our diabetes transition program for our pediatric patients transitioning to adult care begins at the beginning of high school and spans the 4 years leading up to graduation from high school, where they meet certain milestones or goals throughout that period to make sure that they will be independent in their diabetes management by the time they are through the transition program. In addition, we have several providers that provide transition care to adult diabetes care, and this occurs both at Mount Washington as well as at our downtown location. And we are able to transition a lot of our patients to our adult colleagues within the same institution to allow continuity of care within the institution. Additionally, we host a diabetes transition and off to college event for our juniors and seniors who are getting ready and starting to think about college to prepare not only them as students, but also their parents for the time when they will transition to being out of their house potentially and living on their own and making sure that everybody feels ready and comfortable for that transition. We offer a state-of-the-art comprehensive approach to the care of diabetes, both in the inpatient and outpatient setting. Our goal is to make things easier for our families by providing all the resources they would need in one visit. Additionally, then the most important thing is that we can help our children manage their diabetes while also maintaining their normal childhood routines, which is our main goal.
Thank you.